him his head.
I don't think he's got one.
Guess he was scared.
He was scared. I just lost a year's growth. For me, that's something. Gee, George, thanks a lot for saving me.
He'd have done the same for me. I wonder what spooked the herd.
Maybe a mountain lion. Or a wolf pack.
What's the matter, Fury? What is it? There's the answer. Jim said he saw a Pinto stallion running with the herd. Gary, where do you think you're going?
Maybe he wants to be leader, too.
He used to be the leader of that herd. That's while he was wild. Now he's civilized. Gary, come back here! What's the matter with you, Fury? You heard what I said.
He was talking when he should have been listening.
Gary! Come back here. He never acted like this before. Settle down, Fury. Oh, for a minute there, I thought we had a horse fight on our hands.
Yeah. Maybe Fury's not as civilized as you think he is.
Come on, let's find Pokey.
If you ask me, it's a good thing Fury didn't get in a fight with that Pinto. With the saddle and bridle on, maybe he'd have gotten whipped.
Oh, Fury? How'd you like to get into a fight with one hand tied behind you?
I'd have thought of that while the arguing was going on.
Well, what do you think Fury did? He's almost human, isn't he? He'd have figured out he was getting into a one-sided fight. Go have your supper, Fury. He cooked up some bran mash for you.
Maybe he started Pete's cooking.
You heard me, Fury. Now get in the crowd. Fury!
Guy, I thought he was fixing to take off.
Guess that Pinto upset him more than I figured. He'll be all right now. Come on, let's go up to the house and have some cookies and milk.
Joey, look!
Gary! Gary, stop! All right, Gary, you've had your chance. Now you're gonna get punished.
What are you gonna do to him?
Lock him up in the barn.
He won't like it.
I don't care whether he likes it or not. He's gonna stay there till he's ready to start acting human again.
None of us will get any sleep.
Relax, Jim. Joey's got to find these things out for himself.
Pete, you know as well as I do that Fury isn't going to be satisfied staying around here as long as that Pinto stallion's running loose with the herd. The sooner Joey finds out you can't change human nature, the better off we'll all be.
Well, Jim, Joey had his first look at the raw side of nature this afternoon. And that first look can be a little jarring.
And that noise can be a little jarring, too. I guess you'll just have to kick the barn down to prove who's right. If he keeps that up, he's gonna cast himself in his stall and get hurt.
And if we let him out now, this may be the last we'll ever see of him.
It's a chance we're gonna have to take, Pete.
Judging from the sounds coming from that barn, I'd say your discipline wasn't working too well.
Well, I'm not changing my mind. Our teacher says if more parents would carry through when they discipline their kids, there wouldn't be half the trouble there is in the world.
Remember that the next time I punish you. Tell me, is that what you really consider yourself to, Fury, a sort of a parent?
Of course not, but what's the matter with him, Jim? Ever since he saw that Pinto Stallion, I haven't been able to do a thing with him.
Well, I guess even an intelligent animal like Fury responds to the call of the wild when it sounded.
Fury's not a wild horse anymore. He's domesticated.
You almost had it. All right, I'll agree with you on that one point. He's kind and he's gentle, sure. But never forget this, that he was once the leader of that herd. And he doesn't like it one darn bit that another horse is taking his place.
Fury loves me, and I love him. The call of the wild can't be stronger than that.
I don't know whether it is or not, Joey, but I do know one thing, that we have to allow Fury to follow his natural instincts.
That Pinto Stallion is awful big, Jim. What if he...
Fury's pretty good at taking care of himself. Where are you going?
I'm gonna have a talk with Fury, and I'll bet you'd rather stay here with me than be the leader of 10 herds.
I hope so, son. For your sake.
Sorry I had to do this, Fury, but... Well, there's an old saying. Let the punishment fit the crime. Well, you've been just awful. Oh, come on, Fury, settle down. I'm willing to forget everything, if you are. Jim thinks maybe you're more interested in being the leader of a herd than being my pal and living here with me. Before I let you out, I want you to say he's wrong. Oh, come on, Fury, say it. You wouldn't trade all the good times we've had just to be the boss of a herd, would you, Fury? Good boy, Fury. I knew I could talk some sense into you. Now you can come out. I'll let you sleep in the corral tonight. It's a lot cooler in there. Your supper's still waiting for you. Give almost anything, Fury. But not when you lie to me.
Dang mad, that Fury. Might at least have given us a little warning before turning wild on us.
Did you hear Joey's alarm go off? If he doesn't get up pretty soon, he's gonna be late for school. We don't want him to miss breakfast.
He didn't need no alarm to get him up this morning. I don't think he got any sleep all night. I heard him rustling around for the chickens.
What were you doing up at that hour?
Well, I... Same as you, Jim Newton. Oh, I heard you up. I was looking through that window, watching and hoping for a sight of that black horse coming home again.
Yeah, I guess we were all sweating it out last night, Pete. Only this time, it doesn't look as though our collective prayers are gonna be answered.
You really reckon Fury's gone for good this time?
Yeah, and it's gonna break Joey's heart.
Well, I ain't doing so good myself.
Good morning.
Hi, Joey. Pete's got breakfast all ready for you.
I haven't got time.
You reckon maybe you could find time if I was to set a stack of hot cakes and sausage in front of you?
No, thanks, Pete.
Swimming in your favorite syrup?
I'm not hungry.
Oh, wait a minute, Joey. I guess there's no sense in trying to duck this issue. You miss Fury pretty badly, don't you? Well, that's a normal and natural thing. Pete and I miss him, too. But you have to learn to adjust to any situation, no matter how difficult, or you'll ever grow up. Look, you remember that buckskin coat we saw over at McCutcheon's place? How'd you like to have him?
You mean you're really going to buy it for Joey?
Sure.
Why, he's better than any 10 horses I ever seen around these parts.
How about it, Joey? You want him?
I don't want him or any other horse as long as I live.
Going into town to see what happened to that load of clover hay we ordered.
Well, the feed store said they'd have it here by tomorrow. I talked to them a little while ago.
Well, that's what they told us last week, but I ain't taking any more of their dilly-dallying if I have to haul it here myself.
I thought you had some shoeing to do this morning.
Well, I do. What's worse for the horses, going barefoot or going hungry?
All right, Pete, go ahead.
I won't be long. You gonna be here when I get back?
Yeah, sure. Somebody has to mind the store.
Get him up, mister. You know what's good for you, you'll keep him up, too.
Jim Newton, you ain't funny. Even if you think you are.
You're the funny one, Pete. I wish you could have seen yourself reaching for the sky.
Man, you stuck up on me, that's all. I thought you was going to look after the ranch.
Yeah, and I thought you were going to look after the feed. Maybe we're both a little old to be playing games, huh?
Yeah. Okay, Jim. You got me dead to rights. Figured I'd just ride out and see if I could get that black horse anywhere within roping distance. How'd you get here so quick?
I took the shortcut over Indian Mountain.
Any sign of Fury up that way?
I wasn't looking for him. I was looking for you. Look, Pete, I know how you feel, but there's no sense trying to drag Fury in at the end of a rope. We might just as well have kept him locked up in the barn.
I don't know, Jim.
But don't you see that Fury's the only one who can decide what happens from here on in?
You figure he's tangled with that Pinto stallion yet?
Well, I haven't seen any sign of him. The herd's quiet enough.
Well, they sure wouldn't be if them two stallions was around.
Well, it's just a matter of time before they get together. I've seen this happen before. They sort of reconnoiter each other for a while, and then pow, comes the explosion.
Damn blame fools. Trying to kill each other just to be leader of the herd, instead of settling it peaceful-like.
Well, they're animals, Pete. Unfortunately, there are a lot of people like that.
There he is.
He sure looks magnificent.
Looks wild, if you ask me.
He is wild. And free and proud as a king.
Well, I don't know what he's got to be so proud of. He ain't king of the mountain yet. And he ain't a cinch to be as long as that Pinto stallion is to be heard from.
I don't think Fury's as worried about it as you are.
Moving off the hill. We could still get a line on him if we could take him from both sides. What do you say, Jim?
I told you how I feel, Pete. Let him go.
But think of Joey.
I am thinking of Joey. If those two get together again, it'll be because they want to, not because they were forced to.
I guess you're right. me which is worse, being empty-headed or empty-handed.
Pete, I think from now on, the less said about Fury around here, the better off we'll all be. Joey, we're home.
Eh, what's left of the family?
Joey, where are you? I wonder where he is. Had plenty of time to get home from school.
Well, he ain't been here yet. Cookie jar's still full. Reckon we can expect a lot of this from now on. Walking to and from school ain't as fast as riding.
I thought we agreed not to talk about that, Pete.
Hi, anybody home?
Yeah, come on in, Pee-wee, we're here.
Hello, Pee-wee. You see Joey?
Isn't he home yet?
No, didn't you two come home from school together?
Miss Miller made me stay 2 hours longer. We're talking in class. Joey said he had something else to do.
Would he say what it was?
No. He just rode off somewhere.
Well, rode off? He didn't have a horse.
He'd get to use his 22 tomorrow for letting him borrow Pokey.
Where'd he go, Pee-wee?
I don't think I'm supposed to tell. Might get him in trouble.
Listen, Pee-wee, he might get in a lot more trouble if you don't tell. Now, did it have anything to do with Fury?
Come on, boy, talk up.
Listen, Pee-wee, if Joey went out looking for Fury, he could be in a lot of danger. You don't want anything to happen to him, do you?
I told him not to go. I told him Fury and that Pinto Stallion were probably still fighting out there. But he said he had to find Fury and bring him back. He said he'd just as soon be dead if he had to live without him.
You stay here, Pee-wee.
Pete?
Yeah?
Joey will be all right, won't he?
Well, a little praying might help, Pee-wee. You never can tell what might happen in the middle of a horse fight.
Pokey. You better wait here, Pokey. Here.
Heaven, you're safe.
I wouldn't have been if Fury hadn't come along.
You shouldn't have come out here by yourself anyway.
I'm sorry, Jim. I thought if I'd talk to him just once more, he'd change his mind and come home.
Anyhow, that was sure something badly put up. Ain't no doubt who's king of the mountain now.
I guess now he's gone for good. that's the way he wants it, it's okay with me.
Well, you're growing up, Joey. Learning to take the bad with the good. Now, let's go home and get some supper. You can ride double with me.
If you don't mind, Jim, I'd rather walk home. Maybe by the time I get there, I'll be as grown up as you think I am. Fury! It came back! Boy, am I glad to see you. Who do you think you're shoving?
Reckon he figures being leader of the herd entitles him to special privileges.
Fury doesn't care anything about that now. Now that he's shown him who's boss around here, all he wants to be is my pal again. Right, Fury?
Pokey, if that's the last thing I ever do, I'm gonna teach you some manners. Now quit being so stubborn and go in the corral.
Why don't you get behind and push?
Oh, Pete, quit your kidding. Pee-wee's right. Pokey's gotta learn to mind sometime.
Well, I guess there's not a horse trainer in the crowd. We've all had our turn at trying to tame that four-legged demon. Look at him.
Fury hasn't had a turn.
Fury?
Yeah, I'll bet he can do it.
I'll bet he can, too.
I'll believe it when I see it.
All right, stand aside. All right, Fury, how would you get Pokey into the corral?
Thank you.